The first Democratic presidential debates on this very network, only 16 days away now, and we're continuing our series called The Road to Miami, the one where Steve Kornacki tells us everything we need to know about the key states along the teeming I-95 corridor from Maine clear down to Miami. Steve has now crossed from Connecticut into New York, where it was relatively smooth sailing through Westchester County. That's how they draw you in. But now he's hit some of the traffic on the dreaded and feared Cross Bronx Expressway in New York City. Can you hear me, ladies and gentlemen? Back at the big board for us, looking stressed because of his experience, Steve Kornacki. Steve.
Ryan, we were making such good time when we hit Port Chester. I thought we were going to clear the George Washington Bridge inside of an hour, but it has been bumper to bumper on the Cross Bronx Expressway. I don't know what happened here, but it always seemed... let me just roll up the window here, get that, some of that sound out. Oh, that racket has been driving me crazy. That's all about my soundtrack for this trip. But anyway, Cross Bronx Expressway, it is jammed. It is always jammed. It's a tiny stretch just in terms of mileage here. Gets you into Manhattan to the George Washington Bridge. But guess what? There's a reason. This is the most congested stretch of road anywhere in the United States. The Cross Bronx Expressway, where I am right now. People spend 114 hours a year sitting in traffic on this road. That's worse than anywhere else. So that's been the headache I've been, I feel like Gridlock Sam here. That's been the headache I've been dealing with for the last few hours. But we're in New York State for a little while now. We talk about the significance in presidential elections of all these places we pass through when we're in New York State, and really New York City, the Bronx part of New York City heading toward Manhattan. We talk about the curse of the Big Apple mayor. Presidential politics and New York City mayors, they don't seem to agree with each other. Here's what I mean. Here's a New York City mayor who ran for president about a half a century ago, John Lindsay. He was the mayor of New York. He thought it was a great stepping stone. He got in the 1972 Democratic race for president, went down to Florida, lots of transplanted New Yorkers in Florida, and he got 6% of the vote, fifth place. That was the end of John Lindsay's campaign. Go about a generation later, Rudy Giuliani, they called him America's mayor after 9/11. Cover of Time magazine, most popular politician in the country, ran for the Republican nomination, spent $60 million and got one delegate. And that was the end of Rudy Giuliani's race. And now we've got Bill de Blasio, the current mayor of New York, running for the Democratic presidential nomination. New poll in Iowa and... cannot find de Blasio on there, 0%. In fact, he's one of two candidates who in this poll, they said, who's your first choice and your second choice? Nobody said de Blasio for first choice. Nobody said de Blasio for second choice. And also among Democrats in Iowa, 17% favorable, 43% unfavorable. New York City mayors, presidential politics, they don't seem to agree with each other, except I will tell you this. If there's hope for all New York City mayors, it's this man, DeWitt Clinton, a breakaway faction of the Democratic Republican Party of 1812, nominated him for president. So if they ever tell you a New York City mayor can't win a presidential nomination, just remember DeWitt Clinton and try to forget about Lindsay and Giuliani and very possibly de Blasio, Brian.
Steve Kornacki, thank you. Tomorrow night it gets interesting when we cross the border into the Garden State, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Really appreciate this series of reports.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.